So let's discuss about whether we need population standard deviation or sample standard deviation in order to calculate standard error. We know that the formula of standard error equals standard deviation divided by the square root of n. In general, you know that it is population standard deviation. Even my previous lecture, I mentioned that the standard deviation is the population standard deviation. If you read textbooks, you will identify that it is population standard deviation. But in actual situation, most of the situations, we don't know the population standard deviation. And I mentioned in the previous lecture, in such case, we can use sample standard deviation also. Is it true? Because the sample and population totally different things. The population standard deviation is sigma, sample standard deviation is S. So now we have the question whether it is sigma or S. Let's consider whether it is population standard deviation or sample standard deviation using this example. Okay, look at this example. I'm going to do two lectures with this data set. Now, this is the total population. These are true data, population of 3301 pregnant mothers. We have measured the height of them. Among these pregnant mothers, the height is, average height is 154.16, which is the population mean, which is mu, which is a constant. The standard deviation is 5.74. This is sigma, this is a constant. Anyway, using the population formula, we also can calculate the standard error as well. So standard error is 0.1, which is very less. Now our question is whether it is population standard deviation or sample standard deviation. Now, I took a sample using statistical software, random sample of 80% of the individuals from this 3301. So the 80%, approximate 80% is 2299 individuals. Among these individuals, the mean was 154.1, which is almost similar after getting 80%. What is the difference? Very small difference. When the small difference is there, why do we need to measure the total population? It's even 80% is enough. It's not deviated much. Look at the standard deviation. It is almost same as population, but slightly less than this. Look at standard error. It's slightly higher than this value, bit higher. So when you calculate the 95% confidence interval, assuming that this is standard normal distribution, mean plus or minus 2 standard errors, or 1.96 standard errors. So 154.1 plus or minus 2 into this value. So it's approximately 154 to 154.3, very small range. We are very confident about that after taking 80%. Again, I took another sample of 30% individuals from this population, that is approximately 927. I got the value again 154.03, slightly less than the original value. But it's almost same. What is the difference? Is there any practical problem of using this as a mean or this as a mean? No, we can, even 30% is enough to calculate the population mean. Look at standard deviation. It's gradually coming down. But what happens standard error? Even though it is high, again, when you calculate the 95% confidence interval, as I discussed in the previous lecture, again, it will be a narrow range, which should be enough for our purpose. Again, I did I took a sample of 5% of the individuals, which is approximately 173 individuals. Again, I got the mean value of 154.65, which is slightly higher than this one. It is okay. I told you, when the sample is random, either you can get slightly less than value to the population mean, or slightly higher value, or slightly less value to the population mean. So this is slightly higher value. These two values are slightly less than the population mean. Again, it is almost same as this. So why do we need to measure 300,301? Even 5% is enough. 173 is enough to get an idea about the population value, which is again almost same. Look at standard deviation, which is slightly less, but it is a bit higher than this. But standard error is gradually going up. But again, even the rate, 95% confidence interval, will be within 1, it's less than 1, just plus or minus 2 into this value. Again, a narrow range. What's the difference? No much difference than this one. Again, I took 1% of the individuals, which is approximately 28 individuals, and the mean value is 153.19. The mean is not much different, but look at standard deviation, it is coming down and standard error is going up. Maybe based on our purpose, even 28 individuals, 28 random sample of individuals may be enough for this. We can save a lot of money that we are wasting to calculate this one. Again, I took 0.4% of the individuals, approximately 11 individuals. Again, I got the mean value almost same as this one. These are true values, almost same as this one. But look at the standard deviation. It's far less than this, and standard error also slightly higher. 11 individuals, almost same value like population. 11, which is a random sample, may be enough to have an idea about the population mean. But standard deviation is less, standard error is high. Look at standard deviation, standard error. Something strange is going on. When I took 4 individuals, again the mean is almost same, but standard deviation is far less than this one. Standard error is high. Again, practically this also may be enough, but these values are different. Now, our original question was, to calculate standard error, do we have to use population standard deviation or sample standard deviation? Now the question is, what's the difference? For the total population 5.7, again the sample 5.7, 5.5, 5.6. It's no much difference. As the sample size is decreasing, we can adjust the error. So you can identify, when you reduce the sample size, the standard error is going up. But as the researcher, you can decide what is the level that you need. From that level, you can stop. So that may be enough to have an idea about the population. Now the answer is, for the original formula, to calculate standard error, what is the standard deviation? Is it sigma or is it S, or the sample standard deviation? Ideally you need the population standard deviation, but if you don't know, you can go with the standard deviation of the sample, because there's no much difference. But with a very low sample size, the standard deviation is so less, so the standard error is high. Because of that, you need a random sample with adequate size. If your sample is adequate in size, you can use that standard deviation value to calculate standard error. I hope you are clear about that point.